head to the venue now to check in. And we have a competitors meet. Again, today I'm losing my voice. I was losing it yesterday morning, too.
Where are you parked? It's your fault. You were in charge of where the car was.
Well, then you picked the wrong person.
So, yeah, we go check in, and we have a competitors meeting. I don't know if you guys know about the competitors meeting. And then the show starts at 10. Slept, I don't know, 5 or 6 hours, I guess. Pretty solid last night. Nothing too crazy. I don't usually sleep the night before a show. I'll be up just, not really nerves, but just like anxious and excited to get to the show.
How are you feeling right now?
I feel good. I'm a little depleted. I mean, I definitely depleted overnight. Like, carved up, but definitely depleted water overnight. Like, I was peeing all night long. So I have no idea how much I actually lost because we don't have a scale here, but I'd be interested to see what I weighed this morning. But definitely bigger and fuller than I was for the last couple shows, but harder and tighter in the midsection, so it should be a better overall look in general. We'll see what happens. I have my box of Fiji water. So I carry Fiji with me all over the place, these little bottles. Thanks, Rox. Roxy gave them to me. So that, like, I'll bring one of these to the show, and that's perfect for the whole day for me to drink. Always be prepared, like a Boy Scout.
Only you would.
I was
like
never a Boy Scout, I was a Cub Scout.
Water.
Yeah, well,
you are not a Cub Scout.
I was a Cub Scout. I made it all the way to Weeblow. All right, so don't play.
You had the patches and the whole deal.
Fuck yeah.
And that little tie around your neck.
The,
scarf for the yellow scarf.
They call it a. It's got a. There's a name to it. I don't remember what the name of it is, but yeah, I got all the way to Weeblow, which is like
Weeblow.
Bobcat, wolf, bear, and
you're
Weeblow.
Making this up.
No, I swear, people
Come
watching
on.
This right now, they're like, he's right. They're like, holy fuck, he's right. Like, that motherfucker was a Cub Scout. See what happens when you become a Cub Scout? You become crazy later on in your life.
Note to self, never let children become.
Note to self, don't let Jerry know your children at all.
Oh my God.
At all, whatsoever.
All right, let's get going.
All right.
What are you doing?
You have, unless you
baking a fucking cake.
What flavor?
I'm cake on my mind.
Chocolate?
Birthday cake Oreos.
Oh, you know what? I'm with you and your birthday cake Oreos.
Yeah, fuck you and your birthday cake Oreos.
That's like disastrous.
Almost
sure. Almost sure. You getting ready?
A little bit. Trucks feel a little loose because I got. You know
how to. Yikes.
Mass cracks I got?
No, no crack. You're good.
The waiting is the worst part. I hate waiting.
I literally have no idea how
that. It's not a push-up, it's hard when you're fucking waiting.
You haven't had water in how long? I think
it's only like 8-9 hours.
Yeah.
It's been that long.
In China. How'd you sleep?
It was alright, like 5-6 hours. We already went over this in the earlier part of it.
Okay.
Alright, not bad.
Oh my God.
No, you got a photographer shooting from two different directions over there.
And I got you taking pictures of. Oh, wait a minute. I got you taking pictures and her taking pictures all
that.
Together.
That's something.
Everybody's got a camera.
This is the job that I
this
applied
is the
for.
Most photography you've seen back. You guys don't want it.
She beat me up for the job. And it's like, yeah, they were like, we don't pay. And I was like, I'll pay you. Like,
no, I would rather have 2,600 pictures than 26 pictures.
That's the idea. Is you shoot like a shotgun. And if you shoot 100 of them, and 5 of them turn out good, you're plus. Used to be, you didn't know what you had until it was too late.
Yeah.
That's right.
And it cost you all along
right,
the way
back
to find out. Yes.
Back in the day, I think
he's
talking about.
There
for look at me being arrested.
I know, you love backstage.
You gotta be lighthearted about some shit because. Fuck, why is it all tense?
You get a picture of the redhead down there?
I'm sure there are a lot of
redheads. Let me get out of the way.
He's got a good face.
He's got a good face.
Everybody's best.
They all do.
They all smell.
Not just the armpits around here. Smell. I'll just high protein guys.
The hard part.
I know, I'm
really
sorry. This is a real.
Laura hates this part. She's like,
I have the worst job ever.
I know. This is terrible.
When they asked her, she was like, they were like, look, the job doesn't pay a lot. She's like, no, I'll pay you. It's cool. It's
All right, what do you want?
What do you want? I gotta feel up muscly athletes all day. I don't know if I can handle this.
Yeah, that'd be great. I think I'm okay.
Spin move. Face the rear.
Whoa.
Take five steps.
We're face to face now.
You liked it better with your back to his face?
Huh? Yeah, I don't know. Either way, it's gonna look funny, isn't it?
That's why I couldn't do Tandy Tri-Dot. Couldn't have another man at
Tri-Dot. Legs, and then you are done, sir.
The physique guys don't have legs.
I know.
That's what I keep hearing.
A couple bodybuilders might want to borrow those legs, man.
All the beans!
Good? Thank you.
Get it.
Next competitor is going to be number 17. That's Jerry Ward. Next competitor, number 22, Richard Hanks. Number 27, Evan Gottlieb. And our final competitor, number 41, Anthony Barbara III. Folks, let's make some noise for all these gentlemen out here on stage. Back over to our national head judge, Mr. Peter Norton.
Number 41, can you come in between 22 and 17? And face front.
Come on, baby, let's go.
22 and 27. Can you change, please? Grab his hand, each other. And face the rear end, guys. And face front. Judges. Gentlemen, outstanding job. You may turn to your left, your right, sorry, fly off. Your right.
You're right, gentlemen. Following him, you saw before, number 17, Jerry Ward. And our final competitor in this class, number 37, Claudio Reese. Thank you, gentlemen. We'll turn it back over for the call. It's going to be to Peter Gordon.
Gentlemen, do you want anything to step back along? and face front. One more time, go one hand and face that back wall. And face front. Judges. Gentlemen, outstanding job. You can turn to your right and file off.
What you doing, Jerry?
I'm baking the cake again. This time I'm baking cupcakes. Red velvet cupcakes with cream cheese frosting.
Cupcakes.
This is the super glamorous part of competition. Inside an empty auditorium for the next like two hours, I think we got left, till we have the competitors meeting. And I mean, it's a small show, so it went quick. So we left here and went to eat, and with Laura and Michelle. And then Aaron and I went shopping at the mall. We went shopping. I bought a Nike warm-up suit, some new shoes. Big fucking surprise, right?
Shocked.
Like, so we had time to go eat. And we sat around and shot the shit for a while. I thought we'd be there for a long time. I was like, shit, we're going to be late if we get back. Then went shopping. And now we're back and we still have 2 hours to wait. It's the worst part. I fucking hate waiting. It's like, wait when you get here. Wait when you get in the back door on stage. Wait in between shows. Wait backstage to go out there, and it's just the worst part, waiting. I'm so impatient sometimes. Like, I have a lot of patience with some shit, but waiting is not like my forte at all. This is how it is. Like, your show was the same thing. When we went to, I went to eat. When I came back, we were sitting in the fucking front of that auditorium for like 2 hours.
Yeah. It's a lot harder to sit and wait than people realize.
Fuck yeah, absolutely. It's good to have company here. So if someone travels with you to the show and stuff, it's good to have someone with you, because be pulling your hair out. So.
That explains a lot.
Well, 22 years, shows.
It's a long time.
Fucking old.
Yeah. How'd you feel up there on the stage today?
Good. I felt, last night was so much fuller.
Mm-hmm.
And I talked to Rich Siegelman, who's one of the national judges. He saw me at the posing seminar last week, and he's like, "You're so flat." And I tried to explain to him, I was like, "I need to flatten out to get that super tight conditioning. But I'll be full for the show." And he was like, "Wow, you really filled out, but you could be a little bit fuller." Now with me, it's always been, even with bodybuilding, the fuller I get, I take the chance of losing that condition. So I erred, I cautioned on the error side of error. Is that how you say it? Cautioned the side of caution.
Just keep going.
I just
erred on the side of caution. I erred on the side of caution.
I decided to go with conditioning rather than fullness, because you don't want to be on stage and have shit jiggling around and stuff. I'd rather, when I hit my turns and stuff, everything be like super tight, and then go, "Wow, you're too conditioned." Like, okay, cool. So, but other than that, like, my posing felt good this time, and I watched the videos that you took, so I saw that my posing was fluid, and you know, I hit like the arms right and stuff, and the back pose right. And the back pose is what was holding me back. Before, I noticed a couple guys in my class, they were really doing the back pose wrong. So like, they might have been able to beat me if they did it the right way. So we'll see tonight how it, you know, winds up. Looks like maybe first in the masters division. And maybe first or second open. I decided to go open today too.
Nice.
So when I signed up for the show, they didn't have a master's. So they just had open. So I was like, all right. Then they added the master's class. Since I was already registered for the open, I decided to do the open. So I figured I'll hang with the young guys and see where I stack up. It's always good to test your mettle and see, you know, like, yeah, I belong in the old fart class. You know what I mean? Let's face facts. But every once in a while, you're like, look, this old bull's got one more run in him. You want to fuck with these young guys just to be like, I still got it. So you can prove it to yourself.
You can stand next to a 22-year-old and hold your own.
Yeah, hold your own.
You know?
That one kid, if he beats me, the kid's good. I think he should beat me. He's like, good. I think there's no way I should beat him. But, you know, unless my posing was better than his, or for some reason, I get points for that. But I don't see that happening. The kid was good. So if he beats me, he deserves to beat me. So that's just the way I see it.
Right, well, I guess rest, right?
Yeah.
Hang out.
2 hours of rest.
Okay.
Eat some Oreos.
Thank you, Brandon. Next up, competitor number 17, Jerry Ward. Next up, number 22, Richard Hanks. Number 27, Evan Gottlieb. Next up,
number 41, Anthony Barbera, the third. These are our five competitors in men's physique B. Let's please take that fifth place award to competitor 14, Brandon DiCurato. Fourth place award, number 22, Richard Hanks. Third place award, number 17, Jerry Ward. Second place award, number 27, Evan Gottlieb. The first place, number 41, Anthony Barbera. Gentlemen, hands together, raise them in victory. Job well done. Gentlemen, strike the pose before you leave the stage. That's what I'm talking about. Now you may fire off. Moving right along into our... We have three competitors here. First up, number 9, Alexander Young. Number 17, Jerry Ward. Number 37, Claudio Reese. Now let's present those awards. The third place award goes to competitor number 9, Alexander Young. Second place, number 37, Claudio Reese. First place, number 17, Jerry Ward. Well done, gentlemen. Well done. Thank you so very much.
What just happened?
Well, after 22 years of trying to win my class and moving to the national level, 22 years, after all the injuries, after all the setbacks, after all the things that I thought was just over, I just won my class. I won the class at the Del Mar, first place, and I'm now going on to the national level. The idea was to try to get to the national level where I've told that next year when I'm 40, I'll be in the 35 and over 40 class and I'll be competitive for a pro card. I've been told that personally by judges. So I always held myself to the standard that unless I won the class, I would never go to the next level. And I've held myself to that standard for the last 22 years. And after I tore my pec, I thought competition was over. And now it looks like that dream of becoming an IFBB pro is actually could become a reality in the next year. And I'm just sitting back and it's so hard to... articulate what I'm feeling right now to have that first win, to work so hard and like waiting all day to know whether or not you won or not, and to finally just have it happen. I don't know. I mean, I'm talking, but I'm like numb, to be honest with you. I'm completely numb.
So see it. Let's see it.
So it's probably not the coolest trophy you've ever seen in your life.
It's different looking than some of your other trophies for sure.
So it's not the coolest one, but it'll be the most important.
I'm trying to get it to focus. Awesome.
So yeah, so now it's shit, I don't know, like I said, I don't know what to say. I'm talking, but I feel like I'm babbling because I don't know.
Well, you've been waiting for this for 22 years.
What the fuck waits 22 years for shit?
22 years you've waited for this moment.
The important thing, the take-home thing, and you know, like when I walked off stage, I felt proud of myself for the first time in a long time because I didn't give up. You know, through the injuries, through 2 decades of trying to accomplish a goal, I didn't give up. You know, even after I was told by people I was too big for the physique class, drop muscle, like everything that I had to do, I did. And you all have to do it yourself. Like it doesn't matter who's there backing you and supporting you. Like you have to get up and go to the gym. You have to stick to your diet. You have to truck in, day out for 20 plus years to be able to accomplish a goal. And I get my balls busted online all the time. Jerry, when's the last time you won a fucking show? Like nobody can give a shit about your clients or what you can do for them or how you can change your body. Some of those fuckers only care about, Jerry, when's the last time you won your last show? Eat it, bitch.